going through calamities, tragedies, and natural disasters, and living to tell the tale is no joke. During these difficult times, it can be difficult to find the right words to share how you feel or to seek help. We feel hopeless, shocked, angry, insecure, worried, lost, lonely, distressed, or even depressed. Disasters come as swiftly as lightning bolts and often leave without mercy. It is during these moments that we feel the greatest loss of our lives, seeing the damage it has done to properties, finances, and most especially, the way it damages our spirit. It is important to note that experiencing natural disasters or calamities may often lead to trauma. We start to ask a lot of questions like, why do bad things happen to good people? Why did this happen to me? How can I cope with this? Where to begin again? While getting answers to these questions can give us the comfort we need during an utterly confusing time, the next best thing to do is to pause, take a breather, and clear your mind to process the whole experience. Remember that you are not alone. We can easily fall into the trap of thinking that the world is so vast and huge, we are just insignificant beings. But the truth is, many people around us actually care about us. The earlier we get the support and intervention we need, the better. The earlier we can express our thoughts and emotions, the better. Don't hold everything in. A real, sincere connection with one person can make a major impact in our lives. One person or one effort can make a difference. There is no need to rush the coping process. Yes, we do need to get back on track after our lives have been disrupted unsolicitedly. However, there is also great value in taking a few intentional steps, one at a time. One thing that these types of calamities take away from us is control. Getting back on track slowly creates mindfulness, and mindfulness promotes control. When life feels like absolute chaos, set up a new structured schedule or daily routine that can help give you a sense of predictability and control. One of the most critical things to do after experiencing trauma is to limit sources of stress in your life. Give yourself permission to choose your battles. Give yourself enough time and space to first overcome a few essential things before dealing with life-altering decisions. Limit watching the news for a while. Focus on doing something about the things you can control, not on what is out of your reach. Exposing yourself to more stress might trigger intrusive thoughts, memories of the traumatic event, make you feel on the edge, and even give you trouble eating or sleeping. Our bodies have a natural reaction or inclination to cope with stress, and thus, choosing to cope through unhealthy ways like drinking alcohol and other methods of avoidance might possibly lead to our condition getting worse. Instead, we are recommended to engage with the activities we enjoyed before the disaster. Activities like playing sports or games, spending time with family and friends, and doing other hobbies to help us cope in a healthy manner. The beauty of helping others is in the way it is giving us a sense of productivity. Contributing to others enables us to participate in the recovery. This actually helps the whole community reduce the stress everyone is feeling, whether the impact is direct or indirect. This also helps create a sense of pride and purpose. Never underestimate the power of even the simplest acts of kindness. The bottom line is, it matters that we help. Every contribution, large or small, is a step closer to regrowth and prosperity for everyone. Service matters. Standing by each other matters. Through extending gracious support, we are not only building our lives, but we are also building long-lasting teams and relationships that work well together. And lastly, at the end of the day, we go to bed and tuck ourselves in. We are the only ones who can assess where we are in the coping process. We may even feel a syndrome called survivor's guilt, or carrying that feeling of extreme guilt, seeing ourselves survive while others suffer in a much larger scale. It's not anyone's fault. It's not your fault. Let's remind ourselves that guilt doesn't help anyone. To shake it off, try to put your energy and emotion into something else that will benefit you. Acknowledge the small steps you have done to get back on your feet. Remember, recovery is a marathon, not a sprint. Natural calamities leave us changed. No one can experience a magnitude of destruction and not be changed. It will take time to work through it. Everyone processes change differently. You can sit in silence, meditate, take frequent short walks, especially if you're having trouble concentrating on your daily tasks. Be realistic about what you can accomplish in a day, in a week, or a month. Following this is good for healing. Our hearts go out to you. Admittedly, things may look bleak right now, but things are going to get better. We can't imagine what you may be going through right now. But hear this. This too shall pass. You are capable and competent. You can handle this challenge. You have overcome other difficult challenges before this because you are stronger than you think you are. Time alone does not heal. The right action does. I encourage you to do the right things that will facilitate your healing. Be proactive. Reclaim your peace of mind and happiness. Look at the light at the end of the tunnel. If others can go from heartbreak to happiness, so can you.